Thank you. We'd like to start the press conference by Minister Motegi. Minister, please.
Thank you. I have no opening comments, so I would like to take your questions.
Thank you. Then we'll go on to your questions. If you have got a question, please use the microphone that is in the front of this room. Please state your name and affiliation, and then go on to your question. Please ask one question at a time, and please take your seat after one question. So we'll go on to the first question, please.
Thank you. Ishinabe from Sankei Shimbun. I would like to ask about the Senkaku Islands. The Chinese official vessels have infiltrated into the Japanese waters. It's been for two consecutive days. What is your response? And the response from the Minister of Foreign Affairs, please.
Thank you. This year as well, the Chinese official vessels and fishing vessels, we have seen they're coming into the territory, in the territorial sea and the environs. We have on each occasion, have put forward our argument to the Chinese authorities. Next question, please.
NHK, Yamamoto. Mr. Yamamoto from NHK. This is Yamamoto from NHK. I would like to talk about the EPA with the UK. Can you share with us the preparation for the signing ceremony? There has been news reports that the signing will be on the 23rd. Well, with regards to the Brexit and the transitional period will be ended at the end of the year. Therefore, we have been working to sign the Japan-UK EPA in order to maintain the benefits that Japan had enjoyed under Japan-EU EPA and to secure the continuity of the Japanese businesses. So with that in mind, we are aiming for this EPA to come into effect on January 1st next year. This requires the approval of the Diet in the extraordinary session. And with that domestic schedule in mind, we would like to coordinate with the UK side for an early signing. Also, the document will be quite massive. Therefore, we are preparing and legally checking the documents. So it's a very difficult large amount of work, but it's proceeding nicely.
Next question, please. From New Keizai, Kato is my name. I'd like to ask about the oil spill in Mauritius. I understand that it will be 3 months since the accident has taken place last month. I understand that you had a phone talk with the Prime Minister. You talked about providing assistance on an unprecedented scale. Could you please share with us the status of consideration by the Japanese government in relation to this oil spill incident? Well, in August, there was the oil spill incident. As far as the Japanese government is concerned, we take this accident very seriously. And upon the request of Mauritius, immediately dispatched the Japan Disaster Relief Expert Team for more than a month and also provided equipment. And in September, as you pointed out, I had a conversation with Prime Minister Jagannath and stated that we will provide unprecedented scale assistance from medium to long term and also as quickly as possible. As far as the assistance to Mauritius is concerned, as part of the cooperation, we're working to concretize cooperation for ensuring the safety of navigation, restoring ecosystem, and restoring the livelihoods of the local residents. So with the cooperation of various agencies, we are carrying out concrete work. And also during this month, we intend to send a team to carry out survey to concretize the aforementioned cooperation to Mauritius. In relation to such cooperation from Japan, as I mentioned earlier, Prime Minister Jagannath has expressed his appreciation, and we will continue to make close coordination with relevant countries as well as organizations, and we'll render our cooperation for the restoration and rebuilding of Mauritius. Thank you.
Next question, please. Mr. Nakazawa from Kyoto. Mrs. Nakara from Kyoto Tsushin. Under COVID, the various face-to-face diplomacy had been stopped, but this is being restarted. And the foreign minister has been visiting various countries. And so under the new administration of Suga, what would be your diplomacy policy, and how would you like to realize the Japanese visions in terms of diplomacy? So the Abe administration was 7 years and a half, and we have been able to enhance Japan's presence on the international stage. With our diplomacy. And we will maintain this current policy under the new Suga administration. I became the foreign minister September last year, and my view is to provide diplomacy with both tolerance and strength in order to promote a foreign policy that takes a panoramic perspective of the world map. And I have held various talks, including at the United Nations. However, since the COVID pandemic, it has been difficult to have face-to-face discussions since February. However, we have held various TV conference and a teleconference, speaking to foreign ministers around the world 50-60 times during this period. And with regards to countries where the COVID situation has settled down, also there are negotiations that needs to be done face-to-face, for example, the negotiation with the UK. And also, under the COVID situation, there is a growing need for confirming the international cooperation. And that is why, starting from August, UK, we have visited Papua New Guinea, Southeast Asia, Europe, Middle East, and I visited Mongolia during the weekend. And Japan has been promoting free and open Indo-Pacific democracy and freedom and respecting human rights. I have spoken to countries that have the same respect for these values and sharing the commitment to the free and open Indo-Pacific. I think it is very good that there are a growing number of countries that are promoting the free and open Indo-Pacific. Of course, I am visiting foreign countries, but at the same time, the Quad meeting last week, Australia, India, Japan, United States Quad Foreign Ministers meeting was held in order to speak about the various concerns in the international society together. So such a meeting was held in Japan. So this is also very important. And it is not just me, but on the ministry as a whole is preparing for restarting such a face-to-face diplomacy. We will also be utilizing remote measures, but also utilizing a face-to-face. So going forward, we will have a hybrid diplomacy.
Next question, please. Then we'll go on to Takenaka-san from Reuters.
Thank you, Takenaka from Reuters. I would like to ask about the Japan China-Korea summit. According to the domestic reports, it seems that the Japanese side has said that with regard to the former civilian workers issue from the Korean Peninsula, unless acceptable solution is provided to Japan, Prime Minister has said that he will not take part. Can you confirm the reports? Is this true? Well, with regard to Japan-China-Korea summit, at this juncture, inclusive of concrete timetable, nothing has been finalized nor decided. Any other question?
NHK Yamamoto, please.
Mr. Yamamoto from NHK, please. This is Yamamoto. Prime Minister Suga's foreign visit schedule, let me confirm. In the morning, there was an executive meeting of the LDP, and Prime Minister Suga will be visiting Vietnam and Indonesia next week. In order for Japan to contribute to the region's peace and prosperity, he would like to make these foreign visits. So this will be Prime Minister's first visit overseas, and can you explain the significance? I have mentioned earlier that international collaboration is needed more than ever, and in order to realize a free and open Indo-Pacific, this has been supported by many countries.
So against that backdrop, Vietnam will be the chair of the ASEAN meetings this year, and Indonesia is a very major country in Southeast Asia. Therefore, meeting Prime Minister Phuc and President Jacobin and having a summit-level meeting in a frank and open manner to discuss the regional issues, international issues, and response to COVID. To have an extensive meeting, I believe, is very significant. Thank you very much.
If not, we'd like to conclude the press conference. Thank you very much for your attendance.
めくりにお使いくださいっていうのを押すとなんか音が出るのかみたいな。紙めくりに単純に水が置いてあるだけ。